Hey everybody,
JK Callaway here, jumping into season 3 of Ozark. Episode 1, it's called Wartime. That's pretty apropos. I think that's going to be accurate, especially with the Kansas City mob, the cartel, still the Snells, kind of. I mean, Darlene's a crazy bastard. This will be the first time we're putting Ozark on the regular YouTube channel. We're going to do edited reactions here on YouTube, but we will still have full reactions on Patreon. Season 1 and 2, all the full reactions are on Patreon for our $5 backers. If you want to see what I thought about every single episode before this, yeah. But otherwise, I'm excited, man. These first two seasons were killer. So, like I said, last we left off, man, the casino's built. The casino's passed. It's going forward, but, you know, there's that looming issue with the Kansas City mob. They feel like they're getting cut out of the deal, and, you know, I don't think they're big fans of that. So, they've already blown up Marty's office, presumably when no one's in there, because, you know, warning. On top of that, the plan was to get the hell out of Dodge when the casino was finalized, and, Wendy put the kibosh on that. She's like, nah, we're staying here because I said so. So we'll see how that goes over. I don't think it's going to go over well. Meanwhile, Charlotte's still trying to emancipate. Jonah is just all kinds of broken, but putting on that brave face, so we'll see. Ruth's dad is dead. I'm okay with it. The FBI agent's dead. Double okay with it. But Ruth, that's going to be a problem because Ruth is probably going to be the one blamed for the FBI agent's death. I mean, it was Ruth's dad, what, Cade? Ugh. Cade, who actually killed him and hit his body, but Cade's dead now. So they're going to look somewhere else as far as, you know, a culprit, if you will. And it's either going to be Ruth or Marty. Those are the two people they have that have the most gain with the FBI agent dying. More so Marty. But don't discount Ruth. This might turn out real, real bad. Before we get going, make sure you do hit subscribe right down there for me. Well over 4,600, getting close to 4,700. Let's get that to 5K as soon as we can. We'll be doing 2 episodes of Ozark every Wednesday until the season 3 is over. So we'll see what happens. I'm excited. They took their sweet time with this season. Yeah, so hopefully good things, man. Also check out Patreon, patreon.com/JK Callaway. Like I said, full reactions are on Patreon for our $2 backers. Again, if you do want to see season 1 and 2, those are for our $5 backers on Patreon. But every single show we do, full reactions, baby. We're doing Westworld on Mondays, The Walking Dead on Tuesdays, Ozark on Wednesdays, and now we're doing The Chilling Adventures of Sabrina Thursdays and The Haunting of Hill House on Fridays. And I think most of those shows I'm doing with my wife, Siobhan. She's the draw of the channel, let's be real. So, yeah, go ahead and check it out. There's a lot of fun stuff on there. Wartime! Yeah! It's gonna get ugly. I don't know Spanish. Hi. I feel like the hand was enough. Hi. Don't be a dick.
Adios, pendejo.
You still have one box. What, like, close the door. Do you want to be secretive about it? Or you could give a shit and a bunch of money. Oh, wait, what are you doing? Don't just leave it there. Fucking kids. That's fucked. Who is that? And why? And where? And to who? Like, what's the message? Casino time.
Feeling lucky? You've come to the right place.
What did they name it?
Fun in the sun? No problem. 100 ways to win, easy.
Yeah, shut
up. And for those of you who aren't...
Hi, I'm Marty Bird.
And I'm Wendy Bird. If you're gambling on your next vacation, make the smart bet.
Come see us here at the Missouri Bell. We like that's your odds!
Oh, that must have been so much fun for them to shoot.
Good morning, sir.
Look at Ruth.
2 o'clock. Had a road truck stop. I-70.
Did your mom smoke a lot of weed when she was pregnant with you? Huff paint, maybe?
What's your fucking problem?
We need to alter every delivery in case if we're being surveilled. That means different fucking days, different fucking weeks, and different fucking locations. What else you got?
You know, I know how this shit works a whole lot better than you.
It doesn't seem like it.
I'm not going to start laundering again until I feel completely safe. We hired over 200 people in this place. Law of averages tells me the FBI already planted an agent.
Yep.
You should have fucking vetted people better.
Well, it was just me and one other human at a desk. How can I trust that?
What the fuck else is there to trust?
We saw Molly Hatchett open for 38 special.
Dr. Mead.
Oh, Fred.
Is that good?
Well, let's cut right to it, shall we, Fred? What is it going to take to put us over the top and host your convention?
Okay.
REO Speedwagon. If you're the kind of place and get the wagon, you're gonna have yourself a whole lot of dentists.
That is possibly my newest favorite line I've ever heard.
Helen's coming into town. I know you're expecting the worst, but let's preempt that. Picture on the idea of expansion.
What does that mean?
Hotels. Casinos. But we keep the daily operations legitimate. We sell the idea to Navarro as a safety net. We put his share in a trust for his kids. Untouchable. That way, if the cartel war goes south, then he has a whole new revenue stream.
Do you really want to get...
Why? I think that's batshit crazy.
That's... Do you really want to get that involved?
No. It's not. And actually, it was Helen's idea.
I mean, how much more fucking stress do you want to take on?
Right.
This would all be legitimate. Except for the seat money from the drug lord, which, by definition, is not legitimate.
We are pre-approved by the Gaming Commission. No one would question the initial investment. We have Navarro's gratitude. This would only increase it.
Right, but which would eventually make you a target from their enemies.
We're in. I mean, why should the Charles Wilkes's of the world have a stranglehold on this state? I mean, we could have the money and the influence. We could control every political lever in Missouri. We could give millions to the causes that we care about. We could run this goddamn place.
Do you even hear yourself?
No kidding.
I do. Do you hear me?
Good night.
I didn't catch who's... Is this Wilkes's place? No. Wyatt? Well, your hair looks 10 times better. Oh, you simple bitch. You finally learn how to comb your hair, buddy? So whatever you were doing before was horrendous.
Considering the amount of hires that we had to make, there's no way of...
Yes, you don't know who might have infiltrated, so you don't want to launder, I understand.
Just as I'm sure that you understand that I didn't ask to drive to the Ozarks today, but we all have to do things that are outside our comfort zone, don't we?
They think that we killed a Fed.
Launder the fucking money. Starting tomorrow.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Are we good or are we in our feelings?
I'm good.
Would he be open to a solution?
Wendy.
That might alleviate some of his stress. Meaning what? I have a proposal.
You run an high stakes game. If so, I want in.
You're kidding me, right?
I play, I can afford it, I want a seat.
No fucking way.
Sometimes I think you forget who you're talking to.
Because your daddy runs the KC mob. Let me say this as respectfully as I possibly can. Would you please kindly fuck yourself and leave me alone? Thank you.
Casino security was all built around making sure that nobody steals money from the full cash boxes during a pit change. But no one is watching the new empty cash boxes that are replacing them.
So, if those boxes aren't ready lined with cash...
Then our dirty money is in circulation before anyone's even looking.
Yeah.
Seriously, whose house is this? And someone's there.
Mom?
He's squatting.
I'm so sorry.
Why? I don't know you can hear me. Got fucking money in your account. At least use it to bail yourself the fuck out of jail.
What'd the boy do?
Got yourself a drone, huh?
Don't you get involved with that, you piece of shit.
And exploring all our options. It'd be crazy.
So how are you doing this?
Anyway, we'll talk.
Right. Okay.
I need to know why you paid my bail.
I was in the station. It seemed like you needed a break.
You don't even know me.
Well, I admire people who take a principled stand. Especially when it's not the easy choice. If you're not afraid of a little hard work, I'd run a farm. Maybe you and I could come to some kind of arrangement.
Wyatt's still tying some of that hair back like an idiot. Looking like a schmuck. Okay, here we go. We're actually going to meet Navarro for the first time.
Wendy has identified a casino and hotel in Northwest Missouri that needs an influx of cash to survive. I have seen the financials. She is right.
Could give you a foothold.
Why should I be worrying about this now? Please.
Because you might very well be dead in 6 months. We are all parents here. And if this war goes wrong, what can you leave your kids? And in 2 years, if we're not all dead or in jail, what's wrong with millions more in legitimate cash? I've run the numbers, and I really think... I'm sorry.
Honestly, I think that's the longest I've ever seen him sit for a meeting.
They already got some Andy's going. That was betting. That was a lot of limp-ins. It's pretty sad.
Oh, come on. Come on. You really trying to sweat me like that, sir? I'm fucking talking to you.
Dude.
You really think you're gonna bluff me on a flush?
I'm sorry. There's no swearing and addressing others at the table.
How much we got there, dealer? You think this makes you some kind of fucking genius? Asshole! Look at me.
Get him out of here.
sure you want to do this?
With everything I know about you.
Get him the fuck out of here.
Sir.
Did he bust? So if he didn't bust, they just say, hey, you 10-minute penalty or something, you know?
Navarro called Helen an hour ago. He likes the plan.
Doesn't mean we're obligated.
Doesn't mean you're out. Are you nuts?
Yes, it does.
Yeah.
You embarrassed me.
How the fuck did you get back in here?
It's a poker game. People talk shit.
This time, you're gonna get the fuck out, and you're gonna stay the fuck out. Sit tight.
Do you know what your problem is?
Gee, tell me.
Your problem is you're just playing dress up.
I put this game together all by myself. And you fucked it up because you can't bluff well enough to pretend like you belong.
You're a fucking bitch.
And you're a low-rent daddy's boy who can't even pay to get respect.
I should fucking kill you.
Come get yourself.
Ooh. Sit tight.
Stupid bitch! Come on!
Uh-huh.
Fuck.
Yeah. I mean, he's good, right? He's swimming. Right? Check.
God damn it.
I mean, they're going to end up fucking by the end of the season. They're clearly into each other, but... Wow. Well, in a lot of ways, things are going really well. In a lot of ways. Not all of them. I mean, Ruth is going to be in some shit. In theory. But, you know, if the kid's just going to go to his dad. We met the dad with a buddy. And he seems like the kind of cat that would be like, yeah, I'm fine with that. You know what I mean? Like, my son was being a dick. You kicked him in the balls and threw him off the top of the riverboat. Excellent. You know what I mean? Hopefully. We'll see. I mean, if anything happens to Ruth, I will kill a bitch. Ruth is the shit. Wendy going above Marty's head and making a very big deal with Navarro directly. Which, you know, it is legal. I get all that, but that's so big. That's so big. And Marty's, you know, trying to figure out how to find the mole, who's, like, right now, the only character we've met is Frank's son. Don't put it past him to be the guy, to be the FBI guy. Who knows? Like, that's really the only character we've met so far that's one of the employees, for the most part. So, I'm sure we'll meet more, but, poker's fun. I would have liked to seen, you know, what Frank was holding there. Think you bluff me off this? And then he lost. So clearly, no, he wasn't bluffing you. You just suck at poker. Hell of an opening salvo, though. Kind of very clearly says what's going on this season and what direction they're all going and the possible outcomes. So, great opening episode. Can't wait to see more. And thankfully, it's a Netflix show, so we don't have to wait. But unfortunately, the channel and I have a full-time job, unfortunately. So unless you want to tell 50 of your friends to donate $10 a month to me on Patreon, I can't watch them all the time. I'll do two a week. But that's a hell of a one. That was really great. So yeah, can't wait to watch episode 2. We'll do it probably tomorrow, and we'll post it on Wednesday. But yeah, badass. Can't wait to see. Oh, the bullshit that's gonna happen. Oh, I'm scared. Navarro directly. We finally met Navarro.